Hi everybody, I'm Morgan Crosby from Finch Cadillac and you're watching Cars and Crosby. If you've been wondering what Cadillac has been up to in the sedan world, you're not alone. There's a lot of people that don't know that we have an amazing lineup of SUVs and also sedans. Behind me, I have the CT5s and I'm gonna be going through with you guys some amazing features that are on these new vehicles. There's some technology that translates from a brand new C8 Corvette. There's also a new design language that we have to offer called the Y strategy. I'm gonna be going through with that with you guys in a second. And then we're also gonna talk about some cool updates that came to the 21 model year. So if you're interested in buying a cool sedan, I got a car that you might be interested in. Stay tuned, I've got a great episode coming your way. Into it with the Y strategy. I apologize for the wind, guys. It's one of the main reasons why I haven't been filming a lot lately. It's been so freaking windy. We're getting the weather change. I'm kicking the snow because Corvette season's coming about. We're almost got it all gone, and I've got a lot of Corvettes on the way, but we'll talk about that later. Let's go back to the Y strategy, and I've laid it out for you guys here. This is the Cadillac Y that we've been talking about. Here is the entry-level Cadillac. That's a luxury level. So anytime you hear the word luxury, that is the entry-level Cadillac trim. Over there to the right, we've got the sport trim lineup. So if you're wanting more sporty accents, or you're wanting to go into the V-Sport trim line, or even the Blackwing, that's where you're gonna branch off for that. If you're wanting a more traditional Cadillac with chrome and wood and features that are geared towards style and elegance, that's gonna be your premium luxury. So you're gonna branch off over there. And on that, you also have a level above it called the Platinum Premium Luxury. So if you guys are looking at having a more traditional Cadillac experience, that's the route you're gonna go. And so as you can see, they kind of branch off. If you're wanting something more sporty, there's a lot of videos on it right now of the V-Sport lineup. That is where it has the upgraded twin turbo six cylinder, 3 liter engine in it. I have the sister engine to that over there in the premium luxury. We're gonna talk about that as well. But I always like to start off with the basis. This is the baseline. So the luxury trim level and what you get with it. Well, it's 40,000 Canadian. That to start off with is a great price point, especially when you look at what you get as a presence. Now there's no additional upgrades other than the paint. Sorry about that, guys. We have some Canucks that are coming back from the States over here. Welcome back, guys. Sorry about that. We've got a premium paint on here. This is the crystal white. And for the first time, it's not very often that you can get a non-crystal white paint on a Cadillac. I can't think of any other vehicle other than this CT5 where you can get the regular Summit white paint job on a Cadillac. So we'll get back to that, but here is the only exterior option on here other than, I guess, the sunroof, but that's kind of an interior one. And on the outside here, we have our standard rims. They're just a standard alloy rim. You have LEDs all the way around. So every single light on this thing from the exterior is an LED light. And as I've said in previous episodes, Cadillac has to make a presence at night. You gotta know it's something special. And so having a vertical stacked headlight has always been a design cue that every single Cadillac has had since day one. It's a great way to show you that you have something very special coming down the road. And as for you, you know, you have some great visibility. There is a great cutoff in terms of how high this light will come on a vehicle. You wanna make sure that you have a very high bright beam, but you also don't wanna be glaring it into people's eyes. So having a very high-tech light that has a nice cutoff of where, you know, the light will shine onto is a very important thing to consider. And this on the standard level has LEDs all the way around. So that's a great accent and also just safety feature to have. Now, we're also gonna talk about the inside. This has got the sound and sun package on here. And so what that's gonna do is give you the Bose Performance Series sound system. There's 15 speakers that you get in that. And then you have the sunroof, which is in two parts. And the shades actually retract on both of them. So I'll show you in a cool little feature here. Let me just pull this back. And look at that. How cool is that? You get two retractable sunshades. And this is all on the standard model. This is under 50 grand for a performance luxury sedan. And I call it a performance luxury sedan because it's got a 2-liter turbo, but most of the torque you get readily available within the first 1500 RPM of that, which is pretty great. If you're thinking about turbos, you know, I think in the olden days, a lot of people thought of that lag and then you would get that power. But when you have a twin turbo, what you're doing is you're having one of those smaller turbos spooling up the other one. So there's really no lag in between it, and you're getting all that torque at a very low RPM. So having RPM torque very low is a very great thing to have in terms of performance. And then for city driving and everything, it means that you can get going and accelerating and not have to worry too much about having to get up high in the revs to get that power. You're getting it very low, which is for fuel economy, a great thing to have. So we've talked about the luxury enough. Let's get to the fun ones. This over here is the most loaded CT5 that I have on my lot. This is a premium luxury. It has a ton of fun things on it. It also has a nice fancy set of rims on it. This is all kind of blacked out, and you get that traditional chrome pop that you see on a lot of Cadillacs over the years. I like what they've been doing in the C-pillars on the Escalade and then on this one as well, kind of accenting that cool sloped rear end that we have on here. The Cadillac crests have been making a presence on all of the fenders lately. And then the back, we have our regular tail lights. So they're just regularly like a red color. And then if you look over here on the Sport one, all the trim is in black and the tail lights are clear. So the tail lights are different on them. The trim lines are different. The rims are a different option that you can get, and they're accented in a different way. So those are the biggest things on the trims that you can see as a direct difference. I'm going to show you guys some things on the inside now, as there are some cool upgrades that come from the 21 model year that I think you guys are going to be interested in. One last thing before we go on the inside though, let's talk about performance and badging. We've got the 2-liter turbo as an entry level option. It is available in all trim levels. And then we have an upgraded 3-liter twin turbo option, which I have in this one. This is the premium luxury version. So it has 335 horsepower and 400 foot-pound torque. There you can see it. Now this engine first came out in our 2016 CT6. It was the first engine that was twin turbocharged and a V6 that could shut down to 4 cylinders. That brings performance and also fuel economy into the game. And that has to do with the broadband, which we're gonna talk about in a little bit. Now on the V Sport model, it is 355 horsepower and 400 foot-pound torque. Now what's with all these numbers? And then seeing on the back here, a 550T. There's nowhere in the statistics that say that. It's not a 5.5-liter engine like a Mercedes would do. It doesn't have 550 horsepower, so where are they getting that number from? Well, it has to do with our all-electric vehicle lineup that we're having come about. We don't have really a way of showing off the displacement in an electric vehicle or the horsepower, so what we're using is Newton meters of torque. And so what we're doing is we're rounding up to the closest 50 Newton meters, the torque output of all these powertrains. It's something that we have coming about. It's gonna be a really great thing in terms of helping our future generations out with the environment, and I'm very excited to be able to do my part in promoting an all-electric vehicle platform down the road. But for now, we have some amazing vehicles that can shut down when you don't need it in our philosophy called displacement on demand. I forgot one last thing on the outside, and it has to do with the keys. On some of these models, you can get an upgraded Brembo brake system. It's a 4-piston brake system, and as you can see here, it's blue. Now, that's cool in itself, the fact that it's blue, but how cool would it be if you could get your key to match the accents of your Cadillac? Well, you can do that now on the 21 model year. This is one of the cool changes that came about on the model year, and I think that that is just absolutely awesome. Now, on the door handles, you'll see that there's a Cadillac crest. This is how you can get inside of your Cadillac. In all of the vehicles now, we have a passive entry and exit system. It is a standard option, and it's just really great. It means that you don't have to have your keys out when you're getting in and out of the vehicle. You can also use your My Cadillac app to start and stop the vehicle, as this is a great way of getting it primed to go. It's 1 degree Celsius outside right now, and you'll notice that my adaptive heated seats are on and also my heated steering wheel. Now, many of you guys know that I am a Corvette nut. I also like it when we can translate awesome technology from our highly over-engineered products over to other platforms. Now, believe it or not, the CT5 was actually the first vehicle that was introduced with our Global B architecture. Now, that is the computer system that is on all of our future products and also the current ones being released. First clue that was the key. It's the same one as the Corvette. And then I also have noticed that on the 21 model year change, that some of the technology from that translated over to the CT5 as well. What I'm talking about is in your drive mode customization. You have a My Mode where you can adjust different things like steering, brake feel, engine sound all around in here. And it's the exact same as on the new Corvette. So when I change the modes around, you'll see that you get a visualizer showing you what different things have changed on your CT5 when you did that. That is amazing. I love the fact that they've translated that over from the Corvette, or maybe it came from the Cadillac, who knows? I have a feeling it was the Corvette program, but that just goes to show you, when you have an awesome piece of technology, they can share it from one platform to the other, and this was a great addition to the CT5. All right, now the interior. So the underlying theme that you're gonna notice on the Cadillac has to do with redundancy. You have a lot of different ways that you can control your Cadillac, and we don't wanna make it so that you're pigeonholed into doing it one specific way. We're not trying to teach you a second language and then have you do it that specific way. We want it to be intuitive. We want you to be able to use the Cadillac the way that you wanna do it. And we also want the features to work for you as well. If water hits a pothole and splashes onto your front windshield with a bunch of muddy water, we want the rain sense wipers to be able to activate that. If we had a phone and we were using wireless CarPlay and Android Auto, we wanna be able to have a nice large wireless charging pad for you to just be able to lay your phone in and have it charge up. Let's say that you are wanting to change the controls on your vehicle. We've given you a bunch of different ways that you can control this Cadillac and the settings that are in it. We have a mouse system, which is very similar to what you have if you are coming from a German or a Japanese manufacturer vehicle. We have a colored touchscreen display, which is more of your traditional North American way. And then we also have our voice commands, which is the way of the future in terms of giving it the faith that it will listen to what you're saying and actually do it. In previous model years with previous infotainment systems from every single manufacturer, there has been a lot of difficulty in being able to give a voice command to the vehicle and for it to actually complete that. I have faith that you can try this system and you will like it. That to me is adding even more broadband to the ways that you can control your Cadillac. Now, in terms of technology, we've gone a lot further than a normal vehicle. You'll notice that we have a live stream camera mirror here, and this has the ability to adjust the brightness on it. We can increase or decrease the range. This is 300% more visibility than you get out of a regular mirror, and that's gonna give you a lot more confidence when you're on the road and making sure that if there is somebody that's in your blind spot, by the time that they leave this mirror, they're in the blind spot detection system on your actual mirror. So that's even more safety and confidence behind the wheel. Now, in this vehicle, the premium luxury, we have an upgraded infotainment system. And on here, I have a full 8-inch display, which is all digital. I can customize it in a bunch of different ways. I've done some things that I kind of like, which would be your boost from your twin turbos here. You've got your automated headlights, which will change when I turn the steering wheel. I don't know if you guys can see that, but when I turn the steering wheel, the cornering lamps will come on as well, which is another great intuitive idea. I've got a heads-up display system that's on here, and then as well, I have a performance Bose sound system in this one as well. So there's a lot of great features. You know, I'm not gonna rhyme them all off because a lot of them are gonna be very similar to what you would have in your current luxury vehicle, or if you're researching it, then they'll be very similar to those. But the way that we do it is a lot more intuitive, and that's the message that I wanna get across, is we have great technology, but you're not gonna have to read an encyclopedia to use it. That to me is the biggest key to our system. Now, another advantage that we have over other vehicles that are in this class is the rear capacity. In the back of this Cadillac CT5, we have way more space than the competition. I'm talking about the 3 Series, the 4 Series, the C-Class, the S4. Those are the types of vehicles that I see this going against, and we have a lot more space back there. So if you're looking for that broadband, that functionality of being a cool family person that can bring their kids with them but still have some performance, this takes the cake without a doubt. And that to me is the main reason why I think the CT5 is an underrated vehicle that I wanted to get some information across about. I really think that if you look at all the different categories that people look at when they're purchasing a vehicle, this is really gonna check a lot of those boxes that you may not have realized. And it's important to make sure that you understand that with all of our Cadillacs, we give the same experience. So if you're looking at owning this or leasing it, you can have a maintenance program that is complimentary for 4 years or 80,000 kilometers.
And that cost of ownership benefit is something that a lot of people can appreciate. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. We've gone through the why strategy on how we differentiate the different trim levels. We have some cool performance models that are going to be coming out. We have a Blackwing series on the 4 and the 5 already that are planning on being produced the end of this summer, actually. I think that you'll be starting to see some of them. If you're interested in learning more about these products and you're local to the Ontario region, I would love to be able to sit down with you and do a Cadillac session teaching you all about the CT5. I hope you enjoy this video and stay tuned for more awesome content as I have an Escalade episode that's coming about in a couple of days.
Good morning, sun. How are you? Skies above, gee, it's great to be.